Hello everyone, welcome to English class. Today we will cover chapter number 4 completely. The name of the chapter, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. We have been reading this chapter for 2 days and today it is the last day for this chapter. Till now we have read about dogs in the second part, like dog's spirit helped the old couple and they made mortar and mill from pine tree, and then wicked couple brought the mortar and mill and they used the bits of mill as firewood. So let's start reading the chapter and let's see what will happen next. So we will read from chapter number, page number 61, first para of this page, the old man. Yes, the para will start from the word the old man. Okay, so look into your books carefully and listen attentively. You have to note down the meanings of the words which I will tell you. So let's start. The old good man, the good old man humbly asked for the ashes, though the covetous couple turned up their noses at him and scolded him as if he were a thief. They let him fill his basket with the ashes. As we have read at the last, he wanted, the good old man wanted some ash, so he went to wicked man's home. Then he went there and he asked for the ashes. Humbly means kindly asked for the ashes, but the covetous couple turned their noses at him. Turned up their noses means treated him with contempt, with disrespect. Okay, they gave disrespect to the old man and scolded him as if he were a thief and treated him like a thief. They let him fill his basket with the ashes, and afterwards they told him to fill his basket with ashes. On coming home, the old man took his wife into the garden. It being winter, their favorite cherry tree was bare. He sprinkled a pinch of ashes on it, and lo, it sprouted blossoms until it became a cloud of pink blooms which perfumed the air. The news of this filled the village and everyone ran out to see the wonder. So what happened? He came back home and he took his wife. With his wife, he went to the garden. It being winter. Winter means it was winter season, and their favorite cherry tree was bare. Bare means without leaves. Okay, so their favorite cherry tree was without leaves. He threw a pinch of ashes on it. Small amount of ashes he just threw on it, and lo. What does it mean, lo? It means used to attention to an interesting or amazing thing. It is just an exclamatory word here. It sprouted blossoms. Sprouted means produced, and blossoms means buds. Okay, so it produced buds until it became a cloud of pink blooms, and for not making much time, the buds converted into a cloud of pink blooms. Blooms means flowers, masses of flowers. So many flowers blooms, many flowers came there, which perfumed the air. With the fragrance of the flowers, the whole atmosphere filled. The news of this filled the village. Now the news of this blooming incident and like sprouting of blossoms spread around the village, and everyone ran out to see the wonder. And everyone ran out, came there to see the wonder, means how it happened, as the bare tree converted into clouds of pink blooms. Dear student, as you can see on the page number 61, at the end, a picture is given to you, and above the picture, one para and two lines there, and it is followed by to the next page. So I will read it. Look at the page carefully. The covetous couple also heard the story, and gathering up the remaining ashes of the mill, kept them to make with the trees blossom. So at the same they had done before, at the same in this time also, they heard the story about the old couple and the gathering of the remaining ashes of the mill. As they have ashes in their home only, so they gathered up the ashes and kept them to make wither tree blossoms. They also wanted their withered dry trees blossom. blossoms. The kind old man, hearing that his lord, the daimyo, was to pass along the high road near the village, set out to see him. Taking his basket of ashes, as the train approached, he climbed up into an old withered cherry tree that stood by the wayside. So I have read from the of the next page, starting three lines also. The kind old man hearing, as the kind old man heard that his lord, here lord means daimyo, the landlord, as I told you at the beginning of the chapter, was to pass along the high road, main road. On the main road he would pass along and set out to see him. So everybody wanted to see him. The old man, what he did, taking his basket of ashes, he just took his basket, and as the train approached, as the train of daimyo approached, coming near, he climbed up into an old withered cherry tree. There was another old withered cherry tree, so he climbed up the tree that stood by the wayside. The tree was at the side of the road. He just climbed up the tree, and what he did, okay, on page number 62, first para, after four lines, first para is given. I'm going to read it, so please pay attention. Now, in the days of the daimyos, it was the custom when their lord passed by for all the loyal people to shut up their high windows. They even pasted them fast with a slip of paper so as not to commit the impertinence of looking down on his lordship. All the people along the road would fall upon their hands and knees and remain prostrate until the procession passed by. So now they are telling something about the culture, the custom, okay, the tradition. In the days of the daimyos, it was the time of daimyos, landlords, it was a custom is tradition. When their lord passed by, whenever their lord went somewhere from the road, for all the loyal, okay, all loyal people to shut up their high windows. They are not allowed to see them, so they have to shut up their high windows. They even pasted them fast with a slip of paper. Also, they pasted a slip of paper so as not to commit the impertinence of looking down on his lordship. Even they just put the paper on the windows so that they will not look down, commit the impertinence. Impertinence means lack of respect, just kind of crime for them. If they will see the daimyo, their landlord, it will become crime for him. So not to commit the crime, not to show the disrespect, because they wanted to show the respect on him. So they, for not commit the impertinence of looking down on his lordship, they just put paper also. All the people along the road, suppose some people were walking on the road, then what they did, all the people along the road would fall upon their hands and knees and remain prostrate. Prostrate means lying on the ground face downward. Okay, lying on the ground, kneeled down on the knees, okay, put their hands on the road and just facing downwards. It was the position for passing by people until the procession passed by. Till they remain in this position, till the procession is trained, march passed out, the complete march of the daimyo, until the procession passed by, they will remain in the same position. Now next para, the train drew near. One tall, competent man marched ahead, crying out to the people by the way, "Get down on your knees, get down on your knees," and everyone kneeled down while the procession was passing. So the train drew near. Train means complete procession, the march. One tall, competent man marched ahead. So one man, he was very tall and competent, he was marching ahead at the beginning of the complete march past and crying out, and he was shouting and he was informing the people, like, "Get down on your knees, get down on your knees, nobody is allowed to stand, so get down on your knees," and everyone kneeled down while the procession was passing. So at during the procession was passing, everybody was kneeled down. Next para for of this page, suddenly the leader of the van caught sight of the aged man up in the tree. He was about to call out to him in an angry tone, but Seeing he was such an old fellow, he pretended not to notice him and passed him by. So when the Daimyo's palanquin drew near, the old man, taking a pinch of ashes from his basket, scattered it over the tree. In a moment, it burst into blossom. So what happened? As the procession was passing, suddenly the leader of the van, means the Daimyo of that person, leader of the van, caught sight. He just saw that aged man up in the tree. He noticed a man in the tree. He was about to call out to him. He just wanted to call because nobody is allowed to stand like this. Then angry tone and become furious, and he wanted that man down. But seeing he was such an old fellow, but he saw that, noticed that the man was old fellow, he pretended. He pretended means he just behaved falsely, means just ignore him and not notice him, and he just behaved like he had not noticed the man and passed him by, and he passed him. So when the Daimyo's palanquin is the special vehicle for the Daimyo, when his Daimyo's vehicle drew near where the old man was standing, the old man, taking a pinch of ashes from his basket, the old man was in the pine tree. So when the palanquin drew near the cherry tree, the old man took a pinch of ashes from his basket and scattered it over the tree, sprinkled it over the tree, and in a moment it burst into blossom. And the feather tree burst it means there was an explosion of flowers. All the of a complete tree was just explored into the flowers. Two last paras are here of page number 62. The delighted Daimyo ordered the tree to be stopped and got out to see the wonder. Calling the old man to him, he thanked him and ordered presents of silk robes, sponge cakes, fans and other rewards to be given him. He even invited him to his castle. Then what happened? The delighted Daimyo, as he feel the fragrance of flowers, and he, the old man threw the flowers, burst the flowers. So the delighted the Daimyo become very happy, and he ordered the train to be stopped. So he just ordered everybody to stop here and got out from his vehicle and see the wonder, see the magic there. Calling the old man to him, he called the old man to him and he thanked him. He greeted him and ordered. And what he ordered to him, he just present many things like silk robes. Robes means costumes. Silk costumes, sponge cakes, eatable things, fans and other rewards to be given him. So he ordered his servants to just give many presents as you can give to him. He even invited to him to his castle. Castle means fort, palace. He also invited the old fellow to his castle. So the old man went gleefully home to share his joy with his dear old wife. Gleefully means happily. So the old man went back to his home happily and shared these joyful moments with his dear wife. Now, next page, page number 63, first pair of the page. But when the greedy neighbor heard of it, he took some of the magic ashes and went out on the highway. There he waited until the Daimyo's train came along, and instead of kneeling down like the crowd, he climbed a withered cherry tree. So, similarly as greedy neighbor did the same thing before, similarly they wanted wanted to do something to impress the Daimyo. So when the greedy neighbor heard of it, he heard about the happiness of old good man, he took some of the magic ashes and went off on the highway where the march is about to pass. There he waited for some time until a Daimyo's train came along. So he waited there instead of kneeling down, as it was compulsion for everyone to kneel down on the road when the train would pass. But instead of kneeling down, he was not kneeling down at all. He just climbed a withered cherry tree, as the good old man did. He was doing the same thing. He climbed a withered cherry tree. But what happened then? Second last pair of this chapter, not for the day only, for the of the chapter also. I'm going to read, please pay attention. When the daimyo himself was almost directly under him, he threw a handful of ashes over the tree, which did not change a particle. The wind blew the fine dust in the noses and eyes of the daimyo and his wife. Such sneezing and talking. It spoiled all the pomp and dignity of the procession. The man whose business it was to cry, "Get down on your knees," seized the old fellow by the collar, dragged him from the tree, and tumbled him and his ash basket into the ditch by the road. Then, beating him soundly, he left him for dead. So, what happened? When the daimyo himself was almost directly under him. So, when old wicked man was standing in the tree in the wider territory, as the daimyo himself was almost reaching there under that particular tree, he threw a handful of ashes over the tree. So what he did, he just threw the ashes, which didn't change a particle, but the ashes did not change at all, not even a single pinch converted into flour. The wind blew, wind was blowing, and what happened? The wind blew the fine dust in the noses and eyes of the daimyo. Instead of converting it into the flowers, the fine dust went into the noses and eyes of the daimyo and his wife. Such sneezing and choking. Choking means unable to breathe and like cough kind of condition. So when sometimes if we inhale small dust, then we start sneezing and choking. The same happened with the daimyo and his wife. They started sneezing and choking. It spoiled, it disturbed all the pomp. Pomp means celebration, and dignity. Dignity means decorum. Okay, prestige, complete prestige of the procession, the march past, which was going on. This incident disturbed all the celebration and decorum of the procession. The man whose business this was to cry, a man was going ahead of the marching, and it was his duty to say like a cry, "Get down on your knees." He was at the ahead, seized the old fool. He just take out the old fellow from the he just to drag him from the collar of his shirt. He just put down him from the tree and tumbled him. Okay, and tumbled him means dropped down on the road, and his ash basket into the ditch by the road. By the road there was a ditch, there was a gulf. So he just dropped down him and his basket into that particular ditch, and then beating him soundly. And then that person beat him soundly means very soundly. He just beated him, and he left him for dead. Okay, means after getting this kind of punishment, beating him, he got punishment. He was just kicking him and kicking him, beating him with his old tools. He left him for dead. The old wicked person was almost dying. He just reached in the position of dying. So last, what happened? Thus the wicked old man died in the mud. So he was there and he died there after getting this kind of punishment. But the kind friend of the dog dwelt in peace and plenty. Dwelt means settled down. Kind friend means old good man. Dwelt in peace, settled down in peace and plenty. Plenty means he got many good things from the daimyo as well. And both he and his wife, old couple, lived to a green old age. Green old means age means healthy, active and prosperous life. They got this because they were very kind to each and every person, and they kept their dog as a baby, and in return dog helped them for two times. So in this way they got a very healthy and active prosperous life. So it is the end of the chapter, and these are the question answers. Four question answers are there. I will furnish you the answer key. First of all, try to find the answers yourself if it is possible. So thank you so much. Stay tuned for more updates.